Modestas, ready? Bukauskas ready? In the solid black. Kristian Lapsley in the black with yellow trim. Proudly sporting the Norwegian flag. And the firm favourite among the Scandinavian fans, Josh.
Yeah, he certainly is. Let's see how these opening exchanges go. Bukauskas already opening up with some good range finders. Staying fairly well at length. It's good to keep pumping that jab out, try and really establish the range, make the guy think about coming forward. But that's a tremendous amount of distance covered by Lapsley.
And we talked about the unorthodox, the very effective striking style of Dukauskas's combat team, but they've got the submission chops as well. We saw him finish Kalu Editola last time out with a submission. Of course, Corey Tate, one of the more preeminent members to come out of that team over the years. Also, a solid submission artist, an incredible striker himself.
Really set up the submission with strikes.
And the big heater.
Yeah, I mean, you know, Lapsley has a Thai boxing background as well, so he's not going to be a stranger on the field. But tying up nicely with the overhook, he's just off balance. The bigger man just got a little bit more leverage in that position and got over the top of his hips to drive him forward.
Interestingly, Lapsley actually coming off a loss to Peyton Adetola, the man of the Bukauskas beat last time out in London. Read into that what you will, of course.
Really good attempt at a sprawl pass from Bukauskas here. What he's trying to do is flatten Lapsley's left leg to the ground and really just sprawl, make himself very flat and glide his way over the top. But the Norwegian doing a really good job of retaining half guard here. Oh, and he's going to deep half guard. This is some pretty advanced jiu-jitsu. You see Bukauskas is trying to back away. What that's done is allow him to establish a nasty striking range on the ground.
Pounding away, takes the back here, and Lapsley in all kinds of trouble, Josh.
Yeah, and he didn't defend the net, and this is going to be over very quickly. Just a solid squeeze from this point.
Big squeeze from Bukauskas. It's over the jaw. He's trying to tighten it up here.
Lapsley's doing everything right and trying to peel that hand and tucking his chin, and maybe he's going to find some space here. He cannot let that hand go, and he's got to try and hide the chin a little bit more. He can switch to the short choke, and the pressure that's going to be driving through the spine here is going to be significant as well. You can see the left
hook. Oh, and it's over.
No. Solid squeeze. Once he switched to that short choke, you can see he was putting a crank in. But just the angle made me think that perhaps that left artery was still open a little bit and he was trying to turn out.
We saw the switch there to the short choke, as you say, and a brief readjustment there from Bukauskas.
Yeah, so here's the readjustment, and you can see how that bicep's slipping high up on the cheek. It's not necessarily right in on the neck, but look, as he turns over, that right hand sagging to the ground, not maintaining a frame, not appearing to be defending. You completely understand that stoppage.
For my money, the fighter's arm appeared to go limp. It's the right thing to do in that situation to make the call, and referee Rich Mitchell perfectly placed. And we'll throw this one to our MC Andy Friedlander in the cage,
and he will make it official.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Rich Mitchell has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes and 39 seconds of round number one, declaring the winner by submission, Modestas Bukauskas.